Hello everyone, and I'm back. And in the previous lecture, as you know, we were talking about multi-stage network. Of course, this is a terms which we should not use. Double multi-stage is the only thing that is okay. Just I'm saying this one, that is multi-stage networks, it should not be included. Okay, so today we are going to talk about multi-stage networks. So what is it, the multi-stage network, and what is the need of it, and why we want to use these multi-stage network in switching system. The crossbar switching network discussed previously has some limitations as described below. So in earlier we have talked about many switching system, out of which one switching system was crossbar switching system. The number of cross points in crossbar switching, the number of cross points are the square of the number of subscriber, hence this is the costly for a large system. So when we design any switching system, then the total number of n by n crossbar switching system, total number of cross point becomes n square. If we take n by n switching system like this one, this is suppose this is n, this is also n, so this is the n by n cross system, and total number of cross points required were n square. The failure of this was the drawback, of course, because how we will see, the failure of cross point prevents connection with those two subscribers between which the cross point is connected. So if any cross point fail somehow, then rest of the cross points suffer for the connection. So it was the drawback. Even if all the attached devices are active, only few of the cross points are utilized. Other than this one, out of n by n cross points, only few cross points are actively used. So these were some drawbacks of crossbar switching, and that's why it provides that is crossbar switching provides certain disadvantages. More number of cross points are required, as I have told you. For example, we take the example here, for 1000 by 1000 crossbar switching system, 1 million cross points are required. Only to get connected 10,000 subscribers, we need 1 million cross points. This is impractical and inefficient. Okay, it was the drawbacks which we have mentioned in the previous slide also. Fine. Why impractical? Why that and practical 1000 to 1000 and we need 1 million cross point? So why impractical? Prohibitively huge size of the crossbar. Just you can imagine 1 million cross points will take large amount of space and cost. Okay, so it will be somewhere impractical to deploy that system. Why inefficient? Not all the cross point are used at a time. So out of 1000 and 1000, all points are not used. All points are not used. Okay, for example, only 4 cross point are used in the 4 by 5 cross switches, but 20 cross point must be provided. Just we can understand this practicality, that why this is not efficient, because to get connected 40 subscriber, we need 4 by 4 crossbar system which have 20 cross point, but only 4 can be used. So these were the some disadvantage of having crossbar switching system single stage. In order to find a solution to subsidize these disadvantage, the multi-stage space division switches are built. So to overcome or to find the solution of the previous disadvantages, the multi-stage space division switches are used. By splitting the crossbar switches into smaller units and interconnecting them, it is possible to build multi-stage switch with fewer cross points. So by just splitting the crossbar switch into smaller units and then after that interconnecting them, it is possible to build multi-stage switch with fewer cross points. Okay, so how we will do it, we will understand in the next slide. This is the 8x8 multi-stage switch. So one very important thing that if we want to have a 8x8 crossbar switching, so simply it will be 8 inlets and 8 outlets, okay, like 8 8. Okay, but in multi-stage networks we have many stages, not single. This is only single, and then 8. These are, you can see that is 1 2 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8, and these are the outputs, 8 outputs, 1 2, these are the outlets, these are the outlets, and these are the inlets. Okay, now we will try how it reduce the cross point. The multi-stage switch like the above one needs less number of cross points than the ones needed in crossbar switching. Okay, for 8x8 switching, the cross point needed in a normal case network will be square of the of them. That is, if we use that 8x8 crossbar system, then 64 cross points are required. Okay, 64 cross points are required. But when we use the multi-stage network, then in the multi-stage crossbar network only just 40 cross points are enough to get connected. In a large multi-stage crossbar switch, the reduction is more significant. If we go for the larger multi-stages network, more than 3, then of course reduction of the cross point is more significant. And how this is 40, let's get 4x2, this is 8, okay, this is also 8, this is 4, this is 4, and this is 8, and this is 8. I'm showing that how multi-stage network reduce the cross point. 8 plus 8 16, then 16 for so 20 20, then 28 28 to 4 24 to 32, and then plus 8 40. So total number of cross point 40, while in case of 8x8 crossbar system total number of cross points are required 64. So you can just 64 minus 40, that is how many number of switching cross points you are going to reduce, that is 24. I think 24 is not a small number which may be ignored. So this is the advantage of using multi-stage network over single stage network. That's why we go for multi-stage network. So it was the beauty, it was the advantage of having multi-stage switch, that is drastic reduction in the number of cross points. Advantage of multi-stage network, the number of cross points are reduced. Of course, this is the very important point. The number of path of connection can be moved. Other than this one, that is to get connected to many subscriber, it is easier as compared to the single stage crossbar switch system. Disadvantage of a multi-stage network. The disadvantage of a multi-stage network are as follows. Multi-stage switches may cause blocking. Of course, if anyone has certain advantages, then of course it offers some disadvantage. So multi-stage networks may be blocking. What is blocking? That is, if any subscriber is trying to get connected, then it may be blocked. Okay, so what is it? We will see. We will prove the number or size of the intermediate switches, if increased, can solve this problem, but the cost is also incurred. it is though it is disadvantage, but blocking can be reduced by just providing the intermediate switches. If increase, can solve this problem. But but on the other hand, cost may be also increased. So this is a trade-off always. See, this is a n by n two stage network. That is n, and that is number of inlets. These are the inlets. These are the inlets. Okay, so this is a n by n two stage switching network. Inlets, and these are the outlets. Outlets. So this is one stage, first stage, and this is the second stage. This is n inlets and k outlets. So this is a n by k switch. N by k switch. Okay. And the outlets of the first stage goes to the inlets of the second stage. That is k also here. That is whatever k is here. That is equal to k. Okay, so whatever outlet of k is here, it becomes the inlet of the second stage. So this is k by n switching elements switch. Okay, so this is the structure or the diagram of n by n two stage network. Why is two stage? That is, we are having two stages of switching elements, 1 and 2. Okay, now architecture of the general two stage network with multiple switching matrices in each stage. In this one we will see analyze two stage network and with different matrices. So it is a general architecture of two stage networks, and you can see that is there are m inlets. There are the m inlets, and these are the n outlets, and we are having two stages, stage 1 and stage 2, and these are the switching elements used. That are the block of switches 1, 2, and R. And these are the number of outlets of first stage S. And these are the R, which are the inputs or the inlets of the second stage. And these are the Q, outlets of the second stage. Okay. So how it works and how it provides the advantage over the single stage, we will see two stage network. Switching matrix, two stage switching matrix, that is the things which I have shown you in the first stage. In the first stage and the second stage, I am going to show here. That is this one and this one. So this is the first stage, which has the switch of P by S. That is P, this is P, and this is S outlets. So this is the switching elements. This is the P by S matrix. And similarly in second stage, outlets are inlets are the R and outlets are the Q. So this is the R by Q switch. Multiple small size matrices are used in each stage, that is of P and S and RQ, each to be realized in practice. Okay, so much small size that which can be realized practically, flexible in system design, and which can be flexible in design that system. Okay. So this is the diagram belongs to the this stage, first stage and second stages. I think this is clear to you. P are the inlets of the first stage, and Q are the outlets of the second stage, like this one. And then these first stage are divided into blocks of R, and second stage also divided into blocks of S switching elements. Okay, S are the outlets of the first stage, and R are the inlets of the second stage. So we will analyze to that one. M inlets are divided into R blocks of P inlets, such that so M is equal to PR. That is P is the P is the that is P, P are the inlets, and R are P are the this one P, and total R blocks. Okay, total R blocks. So what is the value of inlets? P into R. Similarly, N outlets are divided into S blocks of Q outlets. So that is N is equal to that outlets Q. Q is the outlets and S is the blocks of second stage. So it will be equal to N. Good. M, PR and QS. Switching matrices. अब मैट्रिक्स बनाएंगे इफ़ वी वांट टू क्रॉस बार. एक्चुअली ऑलरेडी वी हैव सीन मैट्रिक्स क्रॉस बार मैट्रिक्स. ओके सो वी विल हैव द पी बाय एस मैट्रिक्स इन वन फर्स्ट स्टेज एंड आर क्यू मैट्रिक्स ऑफ सेकेंड स्टेज. फुल अवेलेबिलिटी कैसे मिलेगी? इफ यू वांट टू गेट द फुल अवेलेबिलिटी देयर मस्ट बी एटलीस्ट वन आउटलेट फ्रॉम ईच ब्लॉक इन द फर्स्ट स्टेज टर्मिनेटिंग एज इनलेट्स ऑन on every block of the second stage. So if we want to get it fully connected, then at least one outlets of this will be the part of this inlets. Okay, general two stage networks parameters. Number of switching elements, as we have explained, this is important to calculate. S is equal to PSR. Okay, PSR plus QRS. PSR कहाँ से है? लेट्स सी. PSR, P देन R. ओके जस्ट वेट. P देन ब्लॉक, टोटल ब्लॉक्स एंड देन दीज आर द आउटलेट्स. सो दिस विल बी इक्वल टू स्विचिंग एलिमेंट्स PSR. देन सिमिलरली QRS. Q इज द आउटलेट्स, R इज द इनलेट्स एंड S इज द टोटल नंबर ऑफ ब्लॉक्स. So it will be equal to, if we know that is M is equal to PS of RP, that is yahan dekh lo, M is equal to PR, this one M is equal to PR, M is equal to PR. Okay, or N is equal to kya hai aapka, N is equal to a QS. Okay, so just remember this value. S is equal to number of switching elements. Kitna hai aapka? M is the total number of inlets and are the total number of outlets. Switching capacity can be the number of links between the first and the second stage. So switching element, that is the capacity to get connected. Okay. And how it will be defined, that is at least there may be number of links between the first and the second stage. So S can be defined as this one, SR. These are S and R. So it will become the capacity of the switching system. If it will work, then the entire system will work. If it will be failed, then entire system will be failed. Okay. So S is equal to SR. Okay, so this is the simple one. Now blocking probability, we have blocking condition. First, if as we know that is a multi-stage network are blocking nature, so call may be blocked, then what will be the condition of that one? The calls are uniformly distributed. Okay, what will be the condition when there may be blocking in the network? The calls are uniformly distributed. The there are RS calls in the progress and RS plus one call arrival. Okay, the calls are uniformly distributed. That is all RS are engaged. ठीक है, and they are in progress. And at the same time, RS plus one call. When RS are busy, then the switching system face one more call, which becomes RS plus one. So in that case, obviously it will be a blocking system. In this case, the blocking probability PB is dependent upon the traffic static. So if the calls are uniformly distributed means that is all inlets are having subscriber on itself, and RS are equal to the number of subscribers. And when they are busy, all of a sudden one more calls arrive in the network. Okay, and that will be the part of blocking. And in that case, probability is dependent upon the traffic static. What is the traffic statics? What is traffic statics? We'll see in the next unit. Okay. Then other condition is blocking probability or blocking condition second. In other case, the calls are not uniformly distributed. In other case, that is in switching system, calls are not distributed. What is the mean of non-uniform? There is a call in the progress from the first block in the first stage to the jth block in the second, and another call originate in the first block destined to the jth block. That is I just can brief up about it. One call is in first stage of first block, and the other maybe jth block in the second stage. That is the call may be in progress in the first stage of any block and the second stage of any block. So they may be randomly in the blocks of first stage and second stage. This type of traffic is known as the non-uniform traffic. Okay, in this case we may calculate PZ. So in that case, when the traffic is or the calls are not uniformly distributed, the probability may be different, and which does not depend on the traffic statics, and it may be calculated as follows. In the second case, when we may calculate PB as follows. Let alpha be the probability that a given inlet is active. Let alpha is the probability that a given inlet is active, then the probability that an outlet at the first block is active. Okay, so this is the probability beta then when an outlet at the first block is active. Okay, so it can be given by P alpha upon S. Okay, just C, P are the inlets of the first stage, alpha, S are the outlets of the first stage, and alpha is the probability of a given inlet inactive in the first stage. The probability that the another inlets become and seek an outer, in that case beta, what is the probability of any inlet to seek other outlet that in the first stage, P minus 1, we are just going to minus 1, one more car has arrived, P minus 1 alpha, so the probability will be reduced, P minus 1 alpha upon S minus 1, as that is outlets, one outlets is engaged here, so we will minus 1, and similarly one inlets is here, so agar a call ke liye probability ye hai, dusri call aati hai, so of course it will be less probability of getting the connection. Okay, the probability that the already active outlet is required is therefore, so what will be the probability of that one? PB is given by P alpha upon S1 minus P minus, that is the probability that already active outlet, ab ye maan rahe hain ke that is us in sabse pehle koi call rahi hogi, that is 1, तो उसे उसमें से ये माइनस कर देंगे वट एवर वी हैव इन द सेकेंड ऑप्शन फॉर द सेकेंड कॉल. ठीक है, सब्सटीट्यूटिंग एम पी इज इक्वल टू एम आर बिकॉज एम इज इक्वल टू आर पी एज वी हैव कैलकुलेटेड. सो आफ्टर कैलकुलेशन दिस इज जस्ट फॉर द प्रोबेबिलिटी ऑफ ब्लॉकिंग द कॉल्स विल बी लाइक इट in which m is the number of inlets, alpha is the probability of getting the connection in the first stage, s are the outlets of the first stage, m is the again inlets, r is the switching, r is the inlets of the second stage, alpha is the probability, r same. So this is the two stage networks. So these were for blocking probability. From above equation, the number of switching elements can be minimized if R and S are as small as possible. So how we will minimize it? From above equation, the number of switching elements can be minimized. So if we want to reduce the switching elements or the probability of blocking the call, then what will be, if you want to reduce probability of blocking, then we have to RS should be small enough. RS must be small. Okay. And on the other hand, if RS are reduced, the blocking probability goes high. So to make switching elements minimize, we will reduce the, we'll keep RS small. But if RS are reduced, the blocking probability goes high. Okay. If we make it, we make RS, which are the denominator, we make it small, then probability of blocking will be high. So we can we'll have a trade-off between the probability and number of switching elements. So R should be optimum. If so, there is a need to choose value of R and S, which are as small as possible, but gives sufficient link to provide a reasonable grade of service to subscriber. Okay, so this is important. This formula is important to design any system. If we will reduce the RS value of R and S, which are the inlets and outlets of first stage and second stage. On the other hand, if we reduce the RS, then blocking will be provided. So we will choose or optimize such a value that there may be less probability of blocking, and system will work for a reasonable grade of service. That a grade of service, I have explained it. It is out of in India. It is set 0.02, that is out of 100 call 2 may be dropped, but 98 must be connected. Okay, so analysis of two stage network. In this condition, if n greater than m, the network is expanding the traffic. So n is the number of outlets, m are the number of inlets, the network is expanding the traffic. So if n, that is number of outlet, are more, then it may be expanding. If n less than m, the network is concentrating. Okay, because agar m kam hai, n zyada hai, to then after certain interval time, if m inlets are free, then it can get connected. If n less than m, the network is concentrated. The traffic when m is equal to n occurs offer deserve attention. Okay, so baseline networks we will discuss in the next lecture. So today this is sufficient. This is sufficient for today.